Music. We can't live without it, or can we?
I'm good here.
Of course not. It goes without saying.
And while we all have our preferences, mine is death metal, Michael Holland reckons you'd go a long way to beat the talent and versatility on show outside a Foursquare store in Northland.
Coming into the little village of Kaio on the way to Kaitaia is where I first saw her, just past the famous Jandal fence. I glimpsed what I thought was a harp. Sure enough, it was. And the music was beautiful.
I'm an out-of-the-box musician. I can't say, well, I like this music or that music. I like everything. This is a bidongo. They use it a lot in West Africa.
Yes, indeed, the most unlikely of musical strains in the most unlikely of places.
Things happen in choir. Sometimes.
And that's the great joy of happening upon Dianne Brown, who's been blind since birth, outside the local Foursquare, where this bloke's been tinkering with his car for hours.
She takes my breath away. Harp, that little twangy thing, and she sings like an angel too, so, yeah, all to make you tingly.
Believe it or not, I'm actually a nervous person. Being on TV.
So you want this over and done with as quickly as possible?
Yes, because it always makes me feel like you're looking in a mirror when you know you've got pimples. You know, one of those magnifying ones. It's right there, you know?
And right there is where her instruments take her, to a place she can envisage in her mind.
It's more a sight for me than a sound. Like sitting in a hot, wet rainforest on your own, you can hear the cicadas and sort of insect life in the background, and I find it very easy to travel, like, in my mind.
Speaking of travel, today Dianne's busking to help fund a trip to a camp to enhance her newfound love of African drums.
She going to Africa, I think it says on her sign.
No, Dannyburg.
Dannyburg? Right.
To learn the African drums.
Got it.
The guy who's running the camp is so good. He is so good.
Where's he from?
He's from Ghana.
Donations for you, my dear?
Oh, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
It's too much. Yeah, no, she's too much.
Watching from his car in between pages from his large print library book,
I bask in her reflected glory.
Dianne's 82-year-old husband, Colin.
We've been together now 10 years and she never ceases to amaze me. She can play 20-odd instruments. I can play one.
I don't play the guitar. Everybody else plays that, so I don't bother.
Very proud, yeah. It's about time she got some recognition, actually.
And as the day winds down, as the maddening crowds thin, a song dedicated to said proud hubby.
Bless. She is so cool.
Dianne is brilliant.
You're the wind beneath my wings.
Gorgeous. You should do a duet. That would be great. And then you would get some serious money to get Dianne to Dannyburg.
Someone's ringing me.